the third column we will call it as JF in short, which is nothing but journal folio. So on the other side also we have the third column as journal folio. Now the last column is meant for amount, so it is the amount column. Now let us discuss what we will be entering into these columns based on the journal entries what we have written previously. So naturally in the date column we enter the date on which a particular journal entry has been written or whatever it is. Now in particulars column, on the usually we put two first. This is a constant, it never changes. So the word two is constant on the debit side. Then after this two, for example, I'm taking this as a cash account. So in a journal entry, if cash account was in the debit part of the journal entry, then I am stating on the debit side the reason for debiting this cash. So in the particulars column on the debit side, we are stating why we are writing this amount in the cash on the debit side. So you can say, for example, if I take the journal entry cash account debit, let us say 25,000 to capital account 25,000. Let us assume this is a journal entry and in this we have debited cash. As a result, this cash is becoming here the name of your ledger. Now cash account debit, so in journal entry you have put this cash in the debit part and the amount is 25,000. Similarly, in the account of cash you are going to write 25,000 on the debit side of the amount column, in the amount column. Now why are you debiting this cash? The reason comes from your journal entry. It is because of capital. So that reason we are writing here as why we are debiting this cash account. Now, so what is journal folio? Journal folio is nothing but, for instance, if I take this journal entry, it might be written on a particular date. So since journal entries are many, you will be consuming lot of pages while writing them. So for us, for reference in future, you might have to again refer the journal when you are looking at your cash account in the ledger. So the page number from which you have brought this posting from the journal is entered in the journal folio column. Let us say this journal entry in your journal book is on, let us say, page number 28. So that page number we will be writing here. Of course, in the problem when it is given, you will be entering, otherwise you will not enter. Now, as usual, now coming to the amount column, we enter, for example, we are taking in our example cash as cash ledger as our example. So in this journal entry, cash account debit 25,000. So what amount that is there against cash in the journal entry only will come on the debit side of this cash account. Please remember, the amount that is there against cash in the journal entry only will come on the debit side of cash account. Now why I am stressing this is, when you post compound entries later, you will get confused. Now, to avoid that, remember, if 25,000 is against cash, that 25,000 only should come in this cash account in the debit side, because the cash is debited in the journal entry. Now, on the other side also, it is same. We have date, we have particulars. Now, on the credit side, usually we use the word by as a prefix. It is a constant. Then, next, I will take one more journal entry to show how we post it on the credit side. So, I'll take a cash transaction in which cash is to be credited. Let us say we have a journal entry, purchases account, debit to cash. So let us say 500. Now, as per the posting, we will be opening purchases account and cash account. Since we are discussing only the format, I'm restricting to the usage of word cash. So, as per this journal entry, you see in this journal entry, cash is on the credit side of your journal entry. So, cash is in the credit part of your journal entry. Now, I am to post this to the cash account because my account opened here is cash. So, what I am doing is, cash account is credited in the journal entry. So I'm in my ledger in cash account, I'll go to the credit side and write 500 because against cash 500 is there in the journal entry. Now, why I'm writing this 500 on the credit side, the reason I have to state, the reason is purchases, the reason is purchases. So I'll say by purchases. So we would be, that is how we would be using our columns in the format of your ledger. So in date we enter the date on which the transaction has taken place, and particulars column the reason for debiting or crediting the account, and ultimately the amount what was mentioned against the ledger in the journal entry.